Hello everyone, and welcome to How Fix It. Today, I have an essential video for you, a step-by-step iPhone battery replacement guide. If your iPhone's battery health is below 80% and draining fast, don't worry, I'm here to help. I'll walk you through the entire process, making it easy for you to replace the worn-out battery yourself and give your iPhone a new lease on life. Before we start disassembling, let me show you the tools you'll need. Screwdriver set, plastic pry tools, suction cup, tweezers, screen disassembly tool, waterproof sealing tape, battery adhesive strips. I have included links to all the tools and spare parts in the video description below. I also advise using a magnetic mat throughout the disassembly process, especially for repairing a device like an iPhone. While disassembling, manage each screw's placement to ensure accurate reassembly. And you don't have to worry about the screws getting lost. They will all securely adhere to the magnetic mat. So, let's get started. Turn off your iPhone and proceed to remove the two screws located near the charging port. Use a hairdryer to heat the bottom edge of the iPhone for approximately 1 minute, ensuring that the screen becomes slightly hot to the touch. Fix the suction cup to the screen's bottom edge and pull it up. Insert the blade into the thin gap between the screen and the chassis. From this position, gradually begin to separate the screen. The gap between the screen and the iPhone chassis is really small and hard to pry, which is why I consider this screen disassembly tool the most effective for safely removing iPhone screens. The adhesive holding the screen is quite strong, and the opening procedure requires some time. If you can't create a gap, heat the screen even more and gently separate the adhesive until you make a sufficient gap to insert a plastic spudger. To avoid damage to internal components, do not insert the tool deep into your iPhone. When opening the top of the iPhone case, avoid pushing the prying tool too deeply into the case to prevent damage to the components of the Face ID module. Open the screen with extreme caution. Make an effort to avoid sudden movements, because the screen is still connected to the main board. Abruptly separating the screen from the iPhone body can damage the screen cable. Remove the screws on the bracket securing the battery and display connectors. Remember, each screw has its place, so keep them organized for later reassembly. Use a plastic spudger to disconnect the battery cable. Next, disconnect the display cables and remove the screen. Now, let's remove the battery carefully. First, let's begin by removing the components that may obstruct the removal of the battery. Thank you. The battery is glued with adhesive strips to the rear case. Use tweezers to grab an adhesive strip and slowly pull it from underneath the battery. Keep the strip flat at the same angle and make an effort to pull it evenly across the entire strip. If the adhesive strip breaks off and remains under the battery, apply some isopropyl alcohol under the battery in the area where the adhesive strip is broken, and allow it to sit for a while. Then, use a wide plastic spatula to gently pry up the battery and remove it. The battery is now released, allowing you to begin its replacement. In the video description below, you will find a link to a compatible battery for your iPhone. It's time to put in the fresh battery. Here's how. Use adhesive strips to secure the battery to the case. Alternatively, you can use double-sided adhesive tape. However, I highly recommend using adhesive strips, as they are easier to remove in case you need to replace the battery again. Installing the battery into the iPhone housing, you should pay close attention to the battery cable connector. It should align and fit the socket on the main board. Now that it's all back together, let's test the new battery. After starting your iPhone, you may see the message, "Unable to verify this iPhone has a genuine Apple battery." Even if you have installed the original Apple battery, this message may still appear. You can ignore this message and it won't bother you anymore. However, please note that you will no longer be able to view information about the battery's maximum capacity in the battery health section. Everything else will work fine. If you're wondering how to remove the battery service message on the iPhone, I will demonstrate this process in another tutorial. You can find a link to that tutorial in the video description below. With the new battery in place, let's reassemble your iPhone. Remove old adhesive tape from your iPhone's case. Thank you. Use isopropyl alcohol and a cotton swab to remove any remaining smaller bits of adhesive. Carefully align the edge of the adhesive tape with the iPhone case. Use a spudger to press all the adhesive into place and around the entire perimeter of your iPhone. Grab the small pull tab and peel the front liner from the adhesive. Press the display around the entire perimeter to secure its position. Then, fasten the last two screws located near the charging port. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more tech tips and guides. Visit our website for more tech insights and do-it-yourself guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. Well done, the repair is now complete. You were on How Fix It, and see you again next time.